What's up guys, Armadize here, and in this video we'll be speeding up Windows 10. So this is like an optimization guide to make Windows 10 feel snappier and faster. These will be my personal 10 tips on how to do it, and let's get right into it. Alright, so with tip number one, you're going to just right click on your start menu and click on Task Manager. This will open up the Task Manager. We can see all the processes, and you want to click on Startup. So here you can see all the programs that start when you just turn on your computer, and you want to reduce these as much as possible, because if you have less programs starting it on your startup will be faster. So what you want to do is just want to find the programs and just disable them. Now I disabled like something like OneDrive because I don't use it, and Dropbox. I don't need Dropbox to start on startup. So you just want to disable these as many as you can, and this will make your computer faster on startup. Okay, tip number two is visual looks and animations. So you want to disable the visual looks, some of them, as many as you can. So what you can do is you can press Windows key and press on pause, and this will open up this menu. It will also open up the start menu, but this will open up this menu. The alternative way to get here is just go here, type this PC, just right click on this, go to properties, and this will open up this menu. Now you want to click on advanced system settings right here. And then you want to click on performance, click on settings, and here you can copy what I have. But basically, you want to disable all the animations. You want to enable a peak, which just allows you to kind of peak like this, which I like. Also, you want to disable the fade, so all the animations have to go away. I disable most of the shadows, except for the shadows on fonts or just smooth edges in fonts. So you want to show window contents while dragging, so just make sure that you won't get that weird thing, like weird box thing. And the only place where I use shadows is for icon labels on desktop, because that actually makes my icon stand out way easier. You can't see the icons right now because I have actually disabled them. But this is what you want to do. You can copy my settings, or you can just play around with this. But once you click apply, this will just make the whole UI way faster, because you essentially won't have the animations. You can see it's like really snappy right now. It's like boom, boom, you know, it's like really good. All right, guys, so tip number three will be to uninstall useless programs and bloatware. So what you can do is actually get a PC software that's called PC Decrapifier to uninstall the software, or you can actually go and do it yourself if you want to do it yourself. And just go into apps and uninstall stuff. So right here you can see all the apps you have. So let's say if I completed a game, let's say I no longer want to play Age of Empires, so I can just click here uninstall. So you know, for games that you may not want to play anymore, you can just uninstall them right here, or just programs, bloatware, things like that. You just want to uninstall it and keep your hard drive clean. So the less programs you have on your on your hard drive, the better, because it will run faster. Now, secondly, as you know, Windows comes with a lot of like apps pre-installed from the beginning. So what you want to do is you want to remove it. So you want to open a PowerShell, and we'll just be opening up this one. Really doesn't matter which one you get. And with PowerShell enabled, I'll put this this command in the description. You just want to click and paste it in here. So this will just remove all the Windows apps that come pre-installed. Something like I don't know. I don't think it's going to remove like most of them, but it will remove a lot of the bloatware that comes. And this is 100% safe. If you want to get some of them back later on, you can do that. But just go on the internet and you can get the commands for just getting the apps. So this is just like a standard command for removing the apps that come pre-installed. And this really does remove a lot. I've already done it on my computer, so I don't have a lot of the apps, and it's just the apps that I have installed currently. And one last addition, you can actually use this. You can also free up space by going to this PC. So just go to this PC. I'm just going to click it here. Click on your hard drive, right click, and go to properties and click on disk cleanup. So right here, you can see it found 9 megabytes. Now, usually after a Windows update, this is really great. You should definitely disk clean your hard drive once there was an update of sorts, because it usually finds way more than just 9 megabytes. But for now, it just found 9 megabytes, which is still great. So you just click clean, and it cleans everything, and that's pretty good. Okay, next step is power options. So power options, just click on your start menu and enter power options. click Enter, and this is just going to be your power options right here. So you want to click from balance. Usually we'll have this on balance. You just want to click high performance. And you also want to change the plan settings. So you want to click on advanced power settings right here. And we're going to change some of the things. So hard drive, especially if you're running on a hard disk drive as a boot drive, you want this to sit to zero. Turn off hard disk to zero, which means never. So your hard disk is not going to like turn off all of a sudden if you leave it or something. That's just bad. So sleep, maybe you don't want to sleep, just click that never. And the most like important one is actually the processor power management. So you want to make sure that it says to 100% on minimum, system cooling policy to active, and maximum performance state also to 100. If this is limited in some way, then your processor is going to just throttle and there's just no need for that. So you want to make sure it's running on high performance. Obviously, it's going to sip a little bit more power, but I think it's worth it for like the extra performance. So just click OK and you're done. Tip number 5 is Windows 10 privacy settings. So as you know, Windows 10 really wants to like find out everything about you. So just go to your settings, go to privacy, and turn everything off. So let's just say right here, you just want to turn all of these off, like literally everything. Go through all of these. Location, I don't want Microsoft to know where I am. Gee. Camera. So if you, some of the stuff, if you use this camera, I don't have a camera, I'm on a desktop. If you have like Skype and you want to use camera, then you should have this enabled and just click on Skype. Microphone, everything is disabled here. Notifications, if you want to get notifications, you can do that. But for everything else, I don't want Microsoft to know anything about me. So all of this stuff is turned off. So just go through these and just click on off. Feedback. Now this you can't turn off, you can only set this to basic, unfortunately. Background apps, just turn everything off and your computer will thank you for it, because this is just this is just a lot of stuff that you really don't need. Now if you want to send Microsoft something, then be my guest, but I would personally would suggest you to turn that stuff off. Okay, so tip number 6 is to enable Windows Defender, or also get a free software by the name of Malware Bytes. So please make sure you have Windows Defender enabled. It really does protect your system. It's not like it's way better than it was before. But yeah, Windows Defender really does find like viruses and stuff. So make sure it's enabled. It will run quick scan, so you can also scan your computer with a quick scan, and it will generally find most of the viruses. Now, I'm not saying you're going to be protected 100%. I don't think that's even possible. But having this protection, it really ensures that, you know, you have some sort of a protection from viruses. And a lot of people say you don't even need a virus software. And I would generally agree. I don't have it. But I will have a link down below to Malware Bytes. Now, what is Malware Bytes? Well, it's actually a really great software for... it's a free software, by the way, for scanning out malware and things like that. So you just click scan, and it will generally find maybe some like just bloatware, things like that, and just tiny viruses that you may not, like the Windows Defender may not have picked up. So this is generally a great idea to have this software, and it's free. So who the hell cares? Tip number 7 is a very easy one, but some people just kind of forget about this one, is to have the latest version of Windows. So to check what version of Windows you have, just click Start and type in WinVir, and this will actually open this command. Alternatively, you can just click your Windows key and plus R, and this will open up the Run menu, and just type in winvir.exe, and it will open up this window. So this window just says stuff that is like what is licensed to, but also tells your Windows version. So OS build version 1709. As I'm making this video, this is the Vault Creators update. Now guys, please update your Windows to the latest version. Don't hold back, because actually the more later versions of Windows, they work better. They increase performance in gaming most of all, and they just generally add more features that are really great. I mean, Windows Vault Creators update is great, and I think that this is just a good practice to have your software to the latest build. Tip number 8 is to disable user account control, or UAC for short. So just type in user account and just click on enter. Now usually this set, I think, to this setting, which means that when every time you open up something, it will say, oh, do you really want to open this up? So making sure that this will be to all the way down, it will not ask you to like confirm if you really want to open the file. Let me be the boss of the computer and tell me when I want to open something up. Just don't ask me like, are you really sure? Like, yes, I'm sure if I'm opening this up. Now, if you're optimizing Windows for someone that is not as skilled in IT industry and may open up like a wrong file, then definitely keep this on something like here or here, because if they open up a virus, that's bad. That's bad news. But generally, if you feel safe doing this, then definitely this really increases the workflow. Windows doesn't ask you. Just click OK and Windows will stop asking you like, do you really want to open this? Like, yeah, of course I want to open this up. All right. Tip number 9 is to disable some of the services within Windows. So just type in here, type in services, click enter, and this will open up the services tab. So first of all, if you're running a hard drive, I'm sorry, not a hard drive, a solid state drive, you want to disable Superfetch. So only disable Superfetch. So let me find Superfetch here. Here it is, Superfetch. So if you have, actually I have enabled. Oh my God, what are you doing here? You want to disable Superfetch because it does nothing if you're running an SSD. These are designed for hard drives. If you are running a hard drive, then don't disable this. This is good. All right, so what services should you disable? Well, there are a lot of services that you want to disable, actually. So you can sort them here and see which ones are running, which ones are not running. And you want to scroll down. And I mainly disable the Xbox ones because... I really don't need them. So Xbox ones, I just have them disabled. So to disable the service, just click right click, go to properties, and just click on stop, and click apply, and click OK. So right here, as you can see, all of these Xbox ones, I have disabled them. I'll put down below which ones you should also disable, which are safe to disable. So just check the description down below to see what services you should disable to see a minor performance increase, or just generally to make your Windows feel snappier. And finally, tip number 10 is to use other free software to really clean your system. So stuff like CCleaner. So everybody's heard of CCleaner. I'll put the link down in the description of CCleaner. You can do a lot of stuff in CCleaner. Obviously, the number one thing is to analyze. You can analyze your computer for, as you can see, 600 megs of files just sitting there doing nothing. You can just run the cleaner, and it's going to clean everything. Now, that's not the only thing that you can do with CCleaner. Things like the registry. You can clean up the registry. Just make sure you back up your registry once you do it, but here it's going to like find stuff that is missing, or just generally needs to be deleted. So just make sure you back up your registry. You don't want to mess up your registry. Very important. And there's also tools such as Uninstaller, which is really useful. The startup one, which we also discussed. You can do it through here as well. And generally, a really great piece of software that you should really have. Another piece of software you should guys definitely get, this which is 100% free, is Defraggler. So this one, I'll put the link in the description below as well. And if you have a hard drive, you need to have the software, because this is basically a really good software for defragging your disk. Now, you may be asking, wait, doesn't Windows have a defragging software? Yes, but this is 100% better because it has options such as shut down after defrag. So you can just leave your computer and defrag it. And once it's done, it's going to shut down automatically, which is, I think, is an amazing thing to have, amazing feature. And in the options, there are a lot of things. You can set the temperature of your, like, you can see, like, statistics of your hard drive, if it's failing or not, which is really good. Now, one quick tip is do not defrag your SSD. This is just bad. So just don't. I think there's an option so you can, uncheck this box so you won't accidentally defrag your SSD, because... just don't do it. I think there's a warning if I try it, but yeah. Don't defrag your SSD. Defrag your hard drive. It will expand the lifetime and make it faster. Okay, guys. Those were the 10 tips to speed up Windows 10. But I have a bonus tip, and that is to get an SSD. Just get an SSD, put your Windows on it, and you will see a tremendous boost in your performance, because SSDs are way faster than hard drives. And I know that SSDs, even right now, are really expensive. But if you want to make that next upgrade, if you're still running on a hard drive as your boot drive, definitely get like the SSD should be on your number one spot just to make the Windows experience feel way snappier. And that's going to be it. So if you enjoyed this video, if it helped you out, then remember to click the like button. You can watch my video about my 5-year-old mid-range GPU. So watch that. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So goodbye.